I'm live.
What can you see over there?
Hey guys, thanks for logging back in. I'm gonna, I'll be with you guys in one, like 15 seconds. Give me 15 seconds and I'll get back on this. Okay, hey guys. How's it going? How's the quality and everything? San Diego, yeah. Oh, hey, Golfaholics. Hey, Marco, how's it going? Yeah, you guys will see a match. You guys will see a match with Marco and I. We are playing tomorrow. And, Brendan, yeah, I'm not on the range, it was putting green. Hey, Michael. Quality is sweet, mate. All right, good. Good. Wait, hey, Dave, how's it going? Yeah, you guys will see a, I'm playing with another golf channel called Golfaholics. He's in the room right now. So tomorrow we're playing at Arroyo Tribuco. Actually, there's a pro at Arroyo Tribuco that I wanted to, interview, called Michael Block. Anyway, that guy has played in the PGA Championship a couple times, and he, I think he played in the LA Open and some other things, and I don't think he was interested in doing an interview. He's a really good player, but whatever. So I'm going to ask him afterwards, maybe try to set something up. But that's the whole thing with the channel right now. I'm not, like, super stoked on doing that many interviews right now. So, yes, I'm still focusing on the right arm only swing. If you guys, YouTube is doing this thing called Super Chat now, so as soon as the comments come up, they like poof away unless you do the Super Chat thing, so they're hard to see. But I'm still doing it. It's a right arm dominated swing. It's not a right arm only swing, but in my putting, the left hand's on there, and that's truly, like, I mean, that is really right arm only. These two fingers are here and the rest is there, and that's really a right arm, you know, rock and push. And then with the full swing, I'm doing more of a it's a right arm dominated move. The thing I've been thinking about recently is, because somebody said, oh, you're so wristy off the ball, you know, when I'm taking it away, it's like that off the ball. It's so wristy off the ball, but I'm thinking it's not really, because if you separate my wrist only alone in the takeaway, it's actually not that wristy on the way back, but my right arm folds immediately right off the ball. So I want to keep, that's why I think, if you guys saw that training aid I used that one time, it was like a tube that went on my right arm here and kept me from, it was like a gauntlet that if I bent my right arm too much, it would actually run into this, so I couldn't. It was a FedEx tube that I cut. So then I had to keep this width here. And actually the swings I made with that thing were really good swings. So Ian came to the golf school in India, and his putting had been terrible. And then we started working on some stuff, and since then he's gone up and down. He's had good rounds and bad rounds. He did switch his putter, which was good. And he said he just figured something out. One of the reasons I wanted to do a live broadcast today was because, and we'll let for more people get into the room, I'll say this again, but I've been trying to arrange the Be Better Golf School in Chicago. I want to do one on May 20th and 21st. But I've been having a very difficult time booking a course out there. When we did it in India, we had courses like literally bidding to have us come. They really wanted us at their course, like, you know, and it was like a bidding thing. So that was awesome. But in Chicago, it's been very difficult to get a course. They don't really understand, like, an outside agency coming in and taking over 8 spots on the range or 9 spots on the range and what we would be doing, and they're just not interested, even though, you know, it'd be a significant come up for them financially and everything. They're just not interested. So I wanted to enlist your guys' help in trying to find, I'm looking to do a golf school in Chicago or in the New York area on May 20th and 21st, and I'd like to get it booked sooner or later. So if you have any inroads on golf courses there, send me an email, bdivorce76@gmail.com, and let me know what you find out, because it has been difficult. I think we're going to be doing one in the Hamptons, but that's not available until July or something. And you know what? It was just so simple and everything out in India, so breezy. I'm almost thinking about doing another golf school out here in July, around the time of the Long Beach Open, so people can go to the golf school and watch the Long Beach Open, which is a super cool thing. So yeah, tomorrow I am brand new Reese Jones course at City Park in New Orleans. Yeah, the thing is, Harborside, Kyle. Yeah, if you know anybody there, I haven't asked them, but that's not one. I've emailed about 100 places. Yeah, White Deer Run would be cool. Yeah, let me know. Kyle and Waldo are both in Chicago. And Embi and friends. Yeah, if you could come up from Indianapolis, that'd be awesome. I've been to Indianapolis once before, and I really liked Indianapolis. Indiana was all I saw of that was truck stops and stuff. But no, I'll send me these ideas in emails. If you know somebody, let me know. But otherwise, just like try to send me ideas of places in the Chicago area. I am okay. Yeah, Louisiana. I just don't think there's a lot of other people in Louisiana that are that jazzed on it, but there sure would be. There are a ton in Chicago, actually. Yeah, you might be right about that. Why didn't you get fit for the Strixon Z765 driver? I didn't get fit for it because I hit it one time. I only hit like 10 balls with it at the Strixon place, and my numbers weren't awesome. I don't know if it was the driver, because I wasn't like flip-flopping between my old one and that one. I don't know if it was the driver or just me at the time, but I didn't hit that driver that awesome. Spin rates were a little high for me. And if I went through the full fitting, I'm sure I could get it dialed in pretty good. But I wasn't, I didn't like hit the ball and feel like, man, this is easy to hit and this is awesome. So I'm thinking about changing out my driver. I could get a Strixon driver like tomorrow for free, but because Eli has been a supporter and a friend of the channel. But I just wasn't totally in love with that driver. I mean, I know guys who use that driver that do love it. But it's not for me, really. The other thing I wanted to talk about today was golf balls. Has anybody else used this golf ball? Let me go grab it from my bag. All right, I got a couple of golf balls here. I wanted to do a thing about any B betters one. ER1, you have an ER2, Chris. You don't have an ER1. Anyway, so I wanted to do this thing about golf balls. So recently, it made me think. So these are a bunch of different kinds of golf balls. So. I was playing in a tournament like a week ago, like 2 weeks ago. It was just like a member guest kind of thing at Hillcrest. They didn't let me film, but a member and a Be Better golfer invited me, so that was awesome. Really cool course. About halfway through the round, just over like on the 11th hole, I had lost the ball. I didn't lose a ball. I think I like just scuffed it or something. So I changed my ball. Normally, I was playing a Strixon that day, and I changed a Strixon yellow. This is what happened. I always lose the yellow balls, and I hit a shot that was in the trees, but it was fine. and I lost the yellow ball. I just always seem to, they just mix in with the grass too much. So I'm not like going to be using yellow balls very often anymore, I don't think. Anyway, so I lost that, and then at this tournament, they gave us a case of the TaylorMade TP5 balls. It's somewhere in my bag, I can't find it right now. So I switched to that, not these, but the TaylorMade TP5 balls. And when I used those, I hit an iron shot on this par 3, and it went 2.5 clubs longer. Like, I hit a pitching wedge like 158 yards or 160 yards. It was like, a pitching wedge for me is normally like 131 or something, and I hit it like 160. It was like ridiculous. And it's exactly the thought in my mind, because I hit a good shot, it wasn't, you know, whatever. But the thought in my mind was exactly what Jason Day said, which was, this is a joke. This is not, it's like a joke. So it's exactly what I thought. I was like, what is that? So I thought, okay, well, maybe that's a one-off or whatever. And I made an awesome up and down. And then I go in the next hole, and then I hit it basically a normal distance with my driver, nothing crazy. And then the same thing kept happening for the back round, the back nine. I kept hitting this ball, the TP5 ball, like 2 clubs longer than normal, only on the iron shots, too. The wedge shots, yes, it was going way, way too far. But like on middle irons, it was just launching forever. So I didn't like that ball at all. And a lot of people said, well, yeah, just adjust your yardages to be able to play the ball. It's just, you can, when I was playing the TP5 ball, I just couldn't guess. I couldn't guess, at least, certainly not in one round. And even after a while, it felt like I would never know for sure how to gauge exactly how far I was going to hit it. So I'm off of that ball. This Nike, let's just go through the ones I have. These are all leftovers from my bag. This Nike ball is, they don't make this anymore, but this is a Bridgestone ball. But so I've come down to in a minute I'll get to this. I'm flip-flopping right now between sticking with the Strixon ball and the Bridgestone ball. This is a Nike ball. They don't make this anymore. But it's basically a Bridgestone ball. The reason I was thinking about Bridgestone was because Garen Rife uses those for all of his putting stuff. And Garen uses that for all of his putting stuff. And he just says that they're made the most consistently. And also my golf spot, he always uses Bridgestone. Like all the different testing companies use Bridgestone just because they can rely on it the most. And I was thinking, like, oh, okay, that makes sense. So the thing about those, the Pro V1 X is the version of this one that I use. When I use the Titleist, I use the Pro V1, the red one. But I'm not crazy about it. Durability wise, it's like not that great. And it's fine. It's just like, it's like a basic level ball. You know, it does everything you want a ball to do. It's, you know, it's fine, except it doesn't wear out. This was my favorite ball ever, was the Hex Black. And actually the HX, what was it, the 56 ball, that would cut really easy. But that ball was so soft around the greens. You could actually dig your thumb into it and cut the cover. Actually, I just did right now with this ball. Yeah, but Hex Black was one of my favorite balls ever. But they don't make that anymore. So Callaway Chrome Soft, I really like that ball a lot. That's a really great ball. And then another ball that I've used recently, here's the Forte. This is that Australian ball, if you guys are in New Zealand or Australia. This is a very good ball. Everything about it is really good. The only thing I don't like about, like, when you talk about Vice or Kirkland or some duck drum over here. When you talk about Vice and Kirkland and all those golf balls, they have this seam right there that I don't like that much. Like all, and just seeing that seam, or seeing too many flat spots on the ball. I saw this thing about aerodynamics with the Callaway ball that I just threw, has, you know, hex dimples, and that's why I was using Callaway for a long time, just because I thought it was better technology and less flat spots. So, but then, and that's the only thing about this ball. And also, the alignment on this ball is very poor. It's not good. It should have just like a straight up line. You know, you can draw a line, but still, like, it'd be nice. So, these balls, the previous edition of the TaylorMade ball, these balls are really good balls. Let's see, is there a seam on this one? Yeah, there is. So, because it made it the same factory as the Kirkland was originally. And on even on this Strixon, it's less of one. Less of a flat spot, you can see, but it's still one. So yeah, but the reason that I'm going with the Strixon ball, obviously because I got like six dozen of them from them. So that helps for sure. But the reason that I emailed them and asked them for balls, because I could probably email most companies and get balls. But the reason I got them was because the pack that I bought of these Strixon balls, they like never, the cover never wears out. You can see like the discoloration. This is a really old ball, so it's not fair, but the cover is super durable. It does everything you want as far as a ball, like low spin off the tee, soft around the greens, putts well, all that stuff. But the cover on this Strixon ball will not wear out. You'll lose this ball before the cover starts getting all scuffed and crazy and everything. So I really like this ball. This is my friend Tony's pain clinic in somewhere in England. It doesn't say where. So he's a osteopath, I think. Anyway, so he gave me this ball. So that was my first. So that's what I'm using right now, the Z-Star XV, but I want to try the Strixon Z-Star, just the regular Z-Star without the XV, which is like more like their Pro V1. I've heard it's a little softer around the greens. Yeah, this is a Z-Star XV. So that's what I'm using right now. And I want to be able to take this camera out as I practice, but if I walk away from this area with the camera, I'll lose my connection and it'll go dead. So I'm gonna go, let's walk it over here and see if I can do this. And feel free to talk amongst yourself, guys. All right, LASIK is definitely worth it. Got the surgery in 2009. Still have perfect vision. Oh, thank you. That's really good for me to know. I'm just so nervous about picking the wrong doctor, and I don't want to go back in for like multiple things. And also, was it really uncomfortable or painful while they did it? Dude, you need to be a gamer and up your data plan. Yeah, I guess so. You're right. Yeah, there's like four people on here that said they're LASIK. Their LASIK wore out after 10 years. But, you know, that's 10 years without glasses, and then you just do it again. But hopefully you would think that LASIK would have gotten a lot cheaper than it has. You know, it's not really gone down that much. LASIK doesn't hurt at all. All right, cool. LASIK is great. Reading glasses eventually, that's fine. LASIK, did it 15 years ago, now need glasses. Need glasses just to read or need glasses for every... Zero pain all game. Don't do... Oh, PK is PRK? That's the one that the Marine Corps does that, right? My brother had PRK. All right. So just hang out. I'm going to go do some putting for a minute.
Is it 714?
Hey everybody, I'm back. Sorry, I don't think I can walk that over. The A swing is really like foldy in the backswing. And it's basically like a fault fix, not so much a something to live by. And I've heard that it's power-wise, it's weak. That's Monty doesn't like the A-swing at all. So he was talking about it. Mostly what I know about the A-swing is from the articles in Golf Digest and then Monty telling me about the things he doesn't like about it. Oh, here's Josh. Is that Dr. Josh? You can have some regression, but depends on your corneal anatomy. The place I went to will do touch-ups for free as long as you go for checkups every year. That's good. Plus size model Tess Holliday boycotted Uber for, I don't know, it's a news alert that came through. Are you going to release the pitching prescription? Yes, I think I am. I'm pretty sure because I know how many people like supported the channel and basically like bought it, and then I can see how many views are on the video. So I think somebody shared it, like, you know, like on a forum or something, and which was annoying, but whatever. I mean, it's my fault for not, you know, actually. Or I didn't want to, you know, I didn't have the money or whatever to build out like a whole password navigation system and everything. So anyway, so somebody I think hacked into it and just gave it away. So, but anyway, no, but I want to, as a thank you for 20,000 subscribers, I wanted to give it away. So it'll be public and live, probably not this weekend, but next weekend, something like that. Can you, yeah, you can do LASIK when you're older. Yeah, Tiger Woods had another surgery today. He, as soon as we saw two swings, and they didn't look good, you know, the swings against his little kid, we saw these two swings, and then he needed another surgery, which has got to be insanely discouraging for him. It's hard to tell if he really wants to play golf or not, but it was real bad news. But man, there's nothing even close to coming, nothing even in the pipeline that could work out to be nearly as interesting as Tiger. The only thing that's remotely as interesting as Tiger is like if Phil gets in contention again. I mean, he's playing awesome. It's so weird to see the dueling paths of their, you know, Phil's just a little older than Tiger. He's like 5 years older than Tiger, I think. But to see both of their careers go, and Tiger just not being able to physically keep it together, and Phil is still, he's like definitely, I mean, one of the best players in the world still, which is really interesting. And there's a lot of guys, you know, in their 40s that have been able to, you know, including Vijay Singh and Jack Nicklaus and Sam Snead and Kenny Perry, Fred Funk. a lot of guys who have been able to compete deep into their 40s and even into their 50s longer. But I don't know. I don't think we're hearing the whole story of what happened with his back. Do you guys think it was a swing-related issue? Do you think the way he was swinging made him, ruined his swing? Or do you think, some people think that Tiger was, when he was really trying to build up his body and lifting weights really hard, maybe he was doing some drugs or something. I mean, some people have said this. I don't believe this. But maybe he was doing some kind of drugs to help him either gain more muscle or recover faster from other injuries. And anyway, so I don't think so. But I think it's a combination of extreme workouts, running in military boots, and like a ton of like running that helped break him down. His swing. So there's like three things. But most of all, more than anything else that nobody really talks about with Tiger, is that he said a couple articles, but he was very proud when he was young, like extremely proud throughout his whole 20s and 30s, that he only slept 3.5 or 4 hours max a night. He would stay up to all hours, like playing video games or watching South Park and stuff. And this is what I heard, that he would stay up like eating cereal, playing video games, and watching South Park. Actually, I don't know if he would play video games, but he definitely would watch cartoons and eat cereal till all hours. And then, he'd crash in bed at like 1 o'clock, and then he'd wake up at like 4:30 and do his whole routine. And years and years and years of basically being sleep deprived. And if you look at his face, you can kind of see it. It's like haggard looking.
Yeah.
So, and then, and he did the surgery, and then I heard last week that he had flown to London or Germany to get, like, that platelet-rich blood-spinning thing. I don't know. Somebody said he did that, but I think they knew for sure he went there, and they were just guessing that that's why he did went there, but nobody knows for real. So, yeah, like I said, it's super chat on this thing now, and it won't let me see your guys' messages for a while. No, you're not the only European in here, for sure. There's other Europeans in here. As long as you count English people as Europeans, which I do. Yeah, right, exactly. Dave said the same thing. I don't know if you count UK, but... All right, so meet Fly on the Wall Brendan, apparently is present while Tiger watches TV and eats. Yeah, that's right. I'm telling you, this is just the reports I had and things that Tiger said that he did. It's not, obviously I wasn't there. Nobody was. But Tiger told us. These are not from third, second hand, or, this is the thing that Tiger said that he did. Tiger said he only slept for 3.5 or 4 hours a night. And Tiger said that he stayed up super late watching South Park and got up super early. And what is that going to do to, if there is any doctors in here, let us know. What do you think that'll do to your body? There's no real way to cheat sleep. You need it. Michael Jackson tried to cheat sleep. Only woman in here? Maybe, Carrie. Actually, there was a woman on the course here yesterday, and I was thinking about you, thinking I should go talk to her and see if she wants to play golf on a vlog, because people would like that. And playing Call of Duty. Yeah, probably, Marco. And Tiger loved to talk to hostesses at Denny's hookups. I don't know. That was the whole thing about that. Brendan, no room to talk about Tiger's face. That's my nephew. Shut up, Jack. I had to look at that name. Yeah, whatever. Yep, he's an old 41. He is. I mean, look at, I don't know. Trump's wife is like a bunch older than Tiger. All right, Max says to start practicing. He's right. All right, I'm gonna try to take this thing over here. If it fails, that's okay. Yeah, I'm playing with Golfaholics tomorrow. Marco is going to help me film on the front nine, and then he's going to film on the back nine, and we'll be split up. The vlogs will be split on the different channels. Marco will bring the drone, which will be fun. We need to get a match between hacks. Yeah. Everybody complains about everything possible on this channel. It's getting annoying, actually. You did, Jordan. You beat me, but you're not a hack, you're a good player. Somebody else have problems with their Evnroll? Is that what somebody said? Yeah, Goat Hill would be a fun vlog. Maybe on a Friday when they have that skins game. How do I read putts? I tried that thing, the Aimpoint Express, but that was didn't really work for me. I just kind of look at it and pick a spot. I try to read it. I just go to a 90 degree angle to it. Like, this is the ball and this is the hole. I walk over here and look at it and just try to read it like a live vlog match. That would be cool. No plans to come to UK, but I would love to. There's a couple of guys that I could collaborate with there. That would be awesome. And I would love to. I'd love to interview Pete Cowan. If this is excruciatingly boring, I apologize. Where are you? This looks like... Yeah, I'm at El Dorado Park in Long Beach, California. Yeah, only true golf nerds are watching. That's true. Thank you, guys. Thanks. Yeah, there's a lot of really expensive... Golf is an expensive... an expensive deal. Oh, thank you. Lal Tan. Plugging in here. Wait. like I said before, I am looking for help on finding a place to do the Be Better Golf School in Chicago or New York area, preferably Chicago. That has the strongest interest for sure. So email me, bedivorce76@gmail.com if you have any good ideas. Some of you guys are already, I think. But I do need help. Yeah, I would love to play Erin Hills. That course looks awesome. Oh, be better with his own form. That's a good idea, Dave. Does anybody know how to set up a form on a Weebly site? As you guys may, I was kicked out of the GolfWorks forum, so. If I make this one, that's 6 out of 7 from about 10 or 11 feet. That's good. But yeah, the one thing I say about putting practice always is that it's not even worth practicing your putting unless the greens are perfect, because it'll just ruin your confidence. And putting is such a thing of confidence that it's a yeah, you just want to do it as like an exercise to build your own confidence. That's why a lot of pros before rounds, they don't even putt to a hole. They'll like Vijay Singh like putts to a tee all the time. So does Matt Kuchar, and a lot of guys like will just putt to the fringe. Yeah, I want you guys to use this as like, as I'm practicing, like this is your own personal forum to just like hang out with other golfers and talk to other golfers, because I know this isn't super interesting. All right, so that was 8 out of 10. So I'll do that a couple times at different points today, and I'll put that in my numbers spreadsheet in the numbers app on the phone. Nicholas made that for me, or made it for himself and then shared it with me. Okay guys, I'm gonna walk this over to the range. We're gonna see if the connection keeps all the way over to the range, and if it does, we'll continue. If it doesn't, it'll be over, but thanks for watching. Right, stay tuned, I'm going to try to take this over to the range. I don't know if anybody... See, I don't even know if there's a spot. There is one spot. Let's see. If this works, that would be awesome. Still alive. Alright guys, let's start hitting some balls actually. I always say I'm not good enough to hit balls without an alignment stick down. Yeah, and if this is boring, I'm sorry, but I want you guys to use this as like a chat room to talk amongst yourself. None of those were good. That was a good one. That was a 5-iron. This is a 7. That was a 7. It was a bad ball, but that was a good shot. Let's see if I can get this up more, maybe. Sorry, guys. It's not letting me see any comments right now. There you go. Oh, hey guys. Hey, Evan, Dan, Andrew, Ed the Golfer, Kevin Boswick, Robert, Parker. Andrew, Jay, thanks for checking in. Switch to a 5. How's it going? That was a really good one.
What's up? Lot of lumber.
There's a Wi-Fi cloud here. So I'm on a
streaming.
Streaming, yeah. Frustrated recently, but good, you know.
Watching your vlogs.
What's that?
We're watching your vlogs.
Yeah, okay, good. Yeah, just as far as like, that is like kind of like tipping point. Like, I feel like I could really take it somewhere big, but I just don't have time.
You know what
I
mean?
Yeah. I just feel like, you know, there's a couple things I could do that I would like to do. I just, so it's kind of, it is what it is, right? Tribuco?
Yeah.
Have you played there?
I think I have.
Is it nice?
I can't remember. I think I have.
It's kind of expensive, so. I heard it's kind of hard, but still fun.
I have to look at the four cards to get there.
It's $100. I think, I'm playing with another channel.
Your swings on the vlog look so much different than in person.
Yeah.
Just the contact doesn't look as pure and stuff. And
like on the vlogs?
Yeah, it's like, you didn't catch that.
I need to up the volume on the hits. I need to, like, spike the volume on the hits.
Just do a soundtrack.
Yeah. I need to take, like, Tiger or Sergio's impact from, like, the Masters, you know? You hear birds tweeting. It's, like, echoing.
Get a bullwhip and back and forth.
Yeah, right. A bullwhip.
God, I cut that one for you.
Backswing, and I'm trying to feel the arms only to P5, which is this arm parallel, and then everything from that point. You go here, and then it's kind of like you see Darren Clark at the when he won the British Open.
Yeah.
Remember his swing was like almost like that. It was like that really compressed but old man kind of look into it.
Yeah,
it
getting very lateral.
On top of it, yeah. Because I don't want to be like hanging, I want everything going this way. And I also don't want to get spin.
Yeah, that's, I'm doing a lot of that with, I was trying to get my hips to open quick, but I wasn't getting my weight shifting. So now I'm working on my weight shifting.
So you're
shift.
Back here with open hips?
Yeah.
Yeah,
but it's still
nasty.
Not even open.
Yeah.
It was kind of working, but my big thing now is keeping my, this arm coming in. Because I'm left, being left-handed, this arm is dead.
Yeah.
So I'm still just like in backswing, I'm thinking about, my arm is pointing at the ground, my elbow, I'm always trying to keep my elbow pointed towards the ground so it wants to come in.
Yeah.
That's my thought.
Instead of letting it get out here.
I'd do this.
Oh, stuck behind,
Yeah, because I would pull with my left so much.
Show us one, Brian.
Just...
You guys want to see a beautiful woman in a shot? Look at this hair. This is the bearded lady. Oh, is that your club? Did you get this trick sign? Oh, no.
Okay.
Yeah. Yeah, that's different. I can see you're trying to change your path more like this. Yeah. You've been golfing, though, huh?
Yeah.
Yeah.
I mean, I've worked like almost 24 hours straight, so I'm a little fried right now.
The last day. What have you been working on?
I got a project with Comic-Con. I mean, E3, sorry, Nintendo.
Oh, is that in downtown LA again?
Yeah.
That's
so
cool.
We're in the midst of a big design push on it today.
For their booth?
Yeah.
When is that show?
It's in June, but we need to get designs.
Will you be able to go to the show?
I probably could, but I never
even. Yeah. That's a hard show to go to. Now it used to be open to the public. Now it's hard to get to.
Yeah, now it's just press pass.
Here.
It's so easy to slow, but trying to get that trigger that makes it move. You actually hit it really nice.
It's funny too, because forever I was so worried about getting offsides, like getting over here now. But it's one of those backwards things where, like, when I was trying to hold the leg, I dump it out forever. And when I tried to dump it out, like this, I'd actually hold it. And it's almost like me having thought of going left like this, actually, by the time I'm here, I'm not, but then I go.
Yeah.
It's weird. It's such a backwards thing.
It's the opposite, right? It's so true. It's ingrained. Yeah. Whatever you think you should be doing, do the opposite. You'll get there.
So, like, flip and drift. Hit him.
So if I hang out here, is this lessons from the pro?
No.
Yeah, it is.
You'll get me lynched. I am doing a live stream right now, though.
Oh, I'm sorry.
No, that's fine. You're okay. How you been playing?
Actually pretty good in the last couple of weeks.
Good. Yeah. Just mentally, whenever anybody asks me how I'm playing, I'm like, oh, real good. Whether or not I'm playing good or not, you know.
That's good.
It's not gonna help my game at all to tell them I'm playing crappy, so.
Really,
I mean, to a point, unless it's been
Until you have that tank rounds, like, oh man, I can't even get off the tee.
Yep. Like, I thought you were playing good. That was a lie.
That was a round.
That was yesterday.
You've got such interesting your first starting sequence is so interesting. It's just
off the ball.
Yeah, your first move is just a very kind of collapsy kind of thing.
That's what people were been saying recently. I was watching it in slow motion, and somebody's like, "Oh, you're like really snatching off the ball like this."
Yeah,
but it's actually when I see it, actually this is not doing that much right off the ball, but the right arm folds immediately.
Yes. That's
why I built that thing. It was like that gauntlet, remember?
Yeah. And I think that's probably
why...
You think I would have
more consistency? But
that's the way that I've been swinging. Really extend back far and don't even worry about the arm coming in.
It's hard to learn.
Just really just stretch back. Even further back. I mean, really, don't worry about your arm coming off as much. There you go. But it's, I mean, you hit well with your swing, so it's one of those things. You don't...
It's hard to change something that works.
I think I would be more consistent if I didn't go like starting a lawnmower right off of it.
Yeah. I mean, the always, you know,
I
the,
do feel
really
like
wide. Yeah, there you go. Just
feels
a wide
so far
swing
away from me.
You still have a tendency to drop that elbow.
What's that?
You still... It's a difference of your practice swing.
Oh yeah, yeah.
That's why I've been really trying to, by pointing the elbow in even and extending it. Just the whole thing, like you're pushing back as far as you can reach. Don't even worry about setting the wrist, because that'll happen at the top. A little bit wrong though.
Do you consider how far your hands go away from your body? Like you try to do this, or does
it's. I think a lot of it is with, if I get too... It's two different ways. Some people like that early, just keeping it into their body and a shorter swing. Some people like a lot wider coming back. And
well, what
drop
I'm
it.
What I mean is something like put it down. So instead of coming back like this, coming in like this.
Hands are straight back. Yeah.
Straight back. Okay.
Yeah. I don't. When I start rolling it.
Right.
It's a swing. I've had all those swings. And,
that's what I've been working on, is trying to bring it in. I mean, in my mind, I think it's in, but it's not really in. It's
drag
just
the hand
straight back. Maybe slightly in.
Yeah. So this is a good path. It's a nice flat, so it gets you.
Oh, I'm trying to do a Mike Malaska thing where you actually try to get the head just slightly in front of the hands as it's coming down.
Yeah, that's a sequence. It's all sequencing,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
That's what everyone struggles with. Yeah. Well, how to get that point.
See the one Mike just put out? Where he's got the guy here, it's his lesson series. He's got the guy here, he's like, there.
Yep. That's actually what I'm thinking of, right? Same thing. That worked.
Yeah, I tried.
That was really good.
Yeah.
And the backswing was good too when you were thinking about that.
But fat left shots is why I stopped.
If you want to shoot, go ahead. Oh, hey, thanks. Wider backswing, it kind of slows down my backswing too. It's kind of, you know, really letting the feel spoil it.
No, it's all right.
Maybe your feet were just maybe a little
open,
just
a
slightly
little.
Open.
Yeah.
Got a big match for the channel tomorrow.
Oh you do?
At Rio Tribuca.
Ah, who's playing?
Against this other guy.
Another vlogger?
What's that?
Another
vlogger. Yeah. Golfaholics. Hey.
Oh, okay.
Together. The one guy's like a 7 handicap and the other guy's like a scratch or a plus.
Both of them are good today?
Yeah, I think so. Oh, that's it.